Oh, I know all of the languages.
All of them.
I cried at the end of that movie, and not because
The very last one? The very last one.
And not, Jill can tell you that I cried. A huge chunk of, like, my childhood. All the times I pretended I was a Jedi with the freaking lightsabers. And the closing is horrible. It's the worst.
That's why you cried? Because it was so bad?
It was so bad. And I was so sad that that part of my childhood was over and that it was ending that way. I felt like I had no real, like, satisfaction or resolution. Like, I wish I was crying out of, like, happiness, but it was sadness.
I love how the background went to warp speed when you got really emotional.
Darth Vader was supposed to be Force Jesus. You know, like, he was made from the midichlorians.
Not,
no dad.
Not quite. Jesus was a little more forgiving. And patient and kind.
Yeah, he was nice to the children. He was nice
that's
to the younglings.
He was supposed to be. He was the prophecy.
Legolas was in The Hobbit.
He was in the book? Really?
I have no clue. I didn't read the books. I barely know how to read.
To me, it seems like you make one movie, if it's successful and we can make more money making more, then you're automatically set, like, signing up for two more, right?
It doesn't age as well as the first one does, you know?
Yeah, I still think you're a little
biased. I think you're biased.
I think you're biased,
so
dude. Dude, I think you're biased.
I got a couple answers for you.
Did anyone watch the SpaceX launch?
Yeah.
You know, like, there was a time when people thought, like, not too long ago, there was a time that people thought we were never going to go into space again. There was a time, like, Homo sapien living in space, right? Which is the one thing that we can do to preserve the species. Because, you know, this planet does not have a good track record of keeping species, right? I mean, like, say what you will about climate change, say what you will about the environmental change and pollution and whatnot. You know, your opinion is moot because 99.99% of any species that has already existed on this planet is now extinct.
The Earth will take back its own eventually.
Exactly. You know, so, I mean, I think this is huge. In that 15 minutes where you're like, you know, what the hell am I doing with my life? Like, you're watching the future happen, dude.
Right?
Like, that's freaking dope.
The thing with the Industrial Revolution is...
My point being is that, like, I think it's incredible that it, like, less than 100 years from the first autonomous cars, we were walking on the moon.
You know, we have computers, and I have computers here, and there's a computer in your phone, and you can build computers now without ever having any kind of knowledge of code or whatever. You could just buy parts and assemble. And, like, I'm not really, like, a Musk fan. I think he's
really not.
A muskrat.
I like Elon Tusk better than Elon
Tusk. Elon Tusk is great. Since, like, I'm not famous at all, I don't know what it feels like to be famous. I don't know. Like, I don't have any clout. None of us have clout, right? We're cloutless. I haven't had clout since the accident. And
thank God.
I was like, what do you think it like feels like to be famous?
I think there's a distinct difference between, like, artists and businessmen who get famous, right? If 100%. If your goal in life is financial success and you hit it, like, you're living large and you're doing exactly what you want, I think a lot of people, like, you know, even Robin Williams and Jim Morrison, like, some of these true artists, like, they're disturbed people. And what disturbs them, you know, is part of what makes them great and produce this product that we love to enjoy. But, like, you wouldn't necessarily have their art without the dark side of who they are either.
Not that I have any clout, but when I've played shows before...
You've established that.
I want everyone to be absolutely sure.
It's clear.
James has no following. He's got no friends. No one to stand up and say, "Hey, this guy knows how to do some shit."
Yeah, I type my name into Google, and the Google's like, "Who?" But But like, like, so like, I know I wouldn't like fame.
Hold on.
There's a cat mewing at the door. Can somebody let him in?
I can't stop it. I don't know how to stop it.
So I don't think I'd like being famous, because whenever you guys suck, you guys, all of you suck. I'm trying to make a point here.
This is just rude.
I was just gonna say, I will definitely be famous for saying the wrong thing at the wrong time. Like, I've become infamous, because I've become the king of that.
I'm warming it up. I'm warming it up right now. All right. If you were in a one-on-one fight with a deer, no weapons, what? How do you think you would do?
Wait,
is it duck size or horse size?
If you got into fisticuffs,
I think I'd struggle a little bit. Probably. That deer.
Listen, I am serious, and don't call me Shirley.
I think Evan would do the worst out of the four of us.
Definitely. I think, yeah, absolutely.
So, I don't know. I think, like, getting control of it's going
to
be a little.
To the death.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yes. It's a hypothetical situation. Why are you overcomplicating it?
Because I overthink things.
Yo, do you think that you overthink too much?
I overthink about overthinking. Chronically.
Same.
Chronically. The only time I stop overthinking about overthinking is when I'm overthinking about something else.
You get distracted.
Yeah.
I think I could totally kick the shit out of a deer. I'm very cocky. I'm borderline arrogant.
Well, James, it's your lucky night. Guys, ladies and gentlemen, we have a surprise. It is Eric, the buck white-tailed deer, weighing in at 220 pounds.